Assalamu alaikum. Hello guys, in this video I'll be talk about connecting rods. So let's start. Connecting rod is actually an intermediate member between the piston and the crankshaft of the IC engine, and it is used to convert the reciprocating motion of the piston into the rotary motion of the crankshaft or vice versa. Now in any connecting rod there is a small end by which it is connected with the piston with the help of gudgeon pin. Then there is a big end by which it is assembled with the crankshaft, and the big end is divided into two parts for the fitting purposes, and then it is tightened with these two bolts. So now here I have two different connecting rods, and you can see it's the smaller end, then there is a shank, and then there is a bigger end, and this bigger end is further divided into two parts connected with these two bolts. And also you can see the bearing surfaces in the bigger end and in the smaller end respectively. Connecting rods are usually made by drop forging, and the materials used to make them are aluminium or steel alloy. You can see these holes on the surfaces of the connecting rod. These holes are used for the lubrication purposes for the connecting rod and as well as the piston of the engine. So now here I have also the gudgeon pin in the smaller end of the connecting rod, by which the connecting rod will be attached with the piston of the engine. So let's talk about this side thrust produced in the cylinder valves due to the motion of the connecting rod, and this side thrust is maximum in the power stroke, in which one side it is more stressed than the other side, and that side is called the major thrust side. And whether it is left handed or right handed, it is depending upon the direction of the crankshaft. If the crankshaft is rotating clockwise, seeing from the front of the engine on which there is a timing chain, then the left hand side will be the major thrust side. And if this crank is rotating counterclockwise, then the right hand side will be the major thrust side and the left hand side will be the minor thrust side. This side thrust is depending upon the L over R ratio, where L is the length of the connecting rod and R is the radius of the crank. So now suppose for the constant crank radius, if the length of the connecting rod is increasing, then the L over R ratio will be increased, and if the length of the connecting rod is decreasing, the L over R ratio will be decreased, and due to decreased L over R ratio, the angularity of the connecting rod will increase and the side thrust will increase, and due to increase in L over R ratio, the engine height will increase. So we have to compromise between the engine height and the side thrust, and normally for small fast moving engines, the L over R ratio is between 3 to 5 and it is sometimes up to 9 for slow big CI engines. So now let's come towards the failure of the connecting rod. Connecting rod is in fatigue constantly, and it can be failed due to the less lubrication, due to bolts defect, and due to physical defect in rod like cracks, etc. And to avoid the failure, usually the cross section of the connecting rod is I section due to its higher moment of inertia. The cross sections are can be circular, rectangular, and S section as well, but normally I section is preferred due to its higher moment of inertia. And as I mentioned earlier, connecting rods are made by drop forging, and the materials used are mild steel, alloy steel, and aluminium alloys. So that's from my side. If you guys have any questions, you can comment below. I'll try to answer them, and don't forget to share and subscribe. Thank you so much.